climbed unexpectedly in March, but starts for single-family homes fell. We have all the details for you. Rogers Healy is with us, owner and CEO of Rogers Healy Companies. Rogers, thank you so much for being with us. So let's talk about what's going on here. You have housing starts, you have permits. What are some of the themes that you're seeing and what took you by surprise?
Yeah, I mean, honestly, none of this really surprised me. If you think about the process, especially for the people that are, you know, building in quantity, it takes a while to get the permits approved. So if you think about it, if you purchased the land, you know, 6, 7, 8 months ago, the process of putting architectural plans together and getting permits approved, that's a 4 to 6 month process, probably at a minimum, especially when you're building on something over 10 acres. So it's not really a surprise. I do think the only thing that could be maybe the gotcha is the fact that 5, 6 months ago, we had all the supplies at an all-time highest grip as far as costs are concerned. So maybe people waited it out a little bit to have stuff like lumber and glass and all that kind of stuff maybe level out, but none of these numbers are surprising me at all.
Right, and you know, I did see home builder sentiment, right? So you have home builders that are feeling a little beaten down, whether it's, you know, you have mortgage rates on the rise, lack of skilled labor, some supply chain issues. I mean, that all still stands right now, right?
Yeah, but again, no matter what the elements are, the one thing that we have more than ever is we have an incredible amount of demand. And when you have people that keep losing out over the past 2+ years, they're going to find a way to make it work. And I think that what's happened, like we talked about, you know, during our conversations before, is that the rule of real estate is going to shift towards affordability. But we're still going to have people in the baby boomer generation that are going to be downsizing, making room for people my age to go buy their homes. They might want to go buy these places, except they're going to pay cash for it. And even with interest rates being over 5%, we still have a historically all-time great real estate market as far as what's affordable. But, you know, it's exactly what we've been saying, you know, to scale.
Right, ultimately, right? So when does something change? Like, when are we at the peak? You know, because you have rates on the rise, you have low inventory, but you still have people that want homes. They want to sell them, they want to buy them. I mean, demand is still there. The movers and shakers are still out there.
Yeah, I think the two elements that are going to potentially carry this for another decade plus, as far as the residential market staying strong, are millennials and then high rental rates. Half people spending $2 to $3 per square foot on a rental, eventually they're going to find a way to go purchase somewhere else. So I really don't see an end in sight at all, whether it's the luxury market, the entry level market, et cetera. But I do think the rental rates eventually will level out. And I think because of that, we'll see the cycles kind of go back to what they were before COVID, where you buy your first house, you're there for 2 to 4 years, you get married, you have a kid, you upsize. And I think that that's going to become kind of the new thing, because the biggest trend that changed over COVID for us was people that historically downsized. They upsize, people that wanted to have room for their grandkids or work from home, et cetera. So we've seen kind of this interesting intersection between what was the old school versus now, and it's given us a runway that we don't have an end in sight for.
Right, so when you think about the regional parts of it, right? Because for example, in New York, I'm seeing rents and buying going like crazy. So, you know, pandemic, what pandemic? And as a matter of fact, we're at 3-decade highs. Do you expect that to happen around the nation, regardless of the hurdles that we're seeing? Like I mentioned, the rising rate environment, slow supply chains, they can't get, you know, washing machines, things like that.
Yeah, I think New York City is a unicorn, and good or bad, I think that's always going to be an interesting case study because, you know, again, what happened is the cliche 22 or 23 year old that moves to New York for a year or two when they graduate college, that didn't happen the last 3 years. They moved back home. Maybe they moved to a version of New York City. So I think the demand is surging with people that historically wouldn't move there at this phase in their life. But yeah, supply chain for getting a washer, my wife and I are having a baby in our crib, was 4 months late, right? So I think that kind of stuff eventually is going to level off, hopefully, because like you said a few minutes ago, we still have a shortage of labor. And when you have people that are specialists in a certain department, that's going to catch up with you some way or the other, to where I think that the cycles are going to become extended. And I think because of that, we're going to have to just deal with it. But yeah, New York is in a league all by itself. But I think places in middle America, that potentially could slow down, because what was the dream a year and a half ago, being home in, you know, Indiana, maybe that's expired by now. They want to go back to New York or Chicago or even Dallas. And I think we're going to see that stuff level out. But I think this is what it is.
Right. And so really, as I think about this now, I mean, one piece of advice someone gave on our air who's in your business said, if you're trying to sell a home, sell it. Don't be greedy. Everybody's trying to get way over asking. And that happens sometimes. You're having a lot of battles. Can you give us some color about some experiences you've had recently? Are you still seeing everything going over ask? Is your advice to just get it out there? Just make us feel like we're really in the real estate business the way you are.
Yeah, so I heard a long time ago that the definition of a good deal is a deal that makes you feel good, right? Historically, a good deal is maybe you're getting 70 cents on the dollar. I think right now, a good deal is a deal that just makes sense. But the problem with selling right now is most sellers are also buyers. So you've got to be realistic, and especially if you're at an entry-level price point, so maybe under $400,000 anywhere in the country, you might get an offer for $450,000 or $500,000, but you got to take that money and roll it into something else. So, yeah, this is the best time to ever sell, or maybe it's not, where if you got to go find something else, you might want to have that property prepared before you even put your house on the market. But, you know, pigs get fat, hogs get slaughtered, and right now is a good chance for pigs to get really, 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 really fat, as long as they have a new place to go to.
Right. Rogers Healy, thank you so much for seeing all the home builders higher today. In fact, they're up 3-4%. Today, I'm glad you were able to be with us. Rogers Healy, owner and CEO of the Rogers Healy Companies. Thanks for joining us on the show.